afternoon. Please remain standing. Good afternoon and welcome, graduates, honored guests, staff members, families, and the community of Ganado to today's commencement exercises for the Ganado High School Class of 2022. I am Mrs. Lucille Sickey, the Ganado High School Principal, and your Master of Ceremonies for this event. At this time, please welcome to the stage Ms. Ariana Holliday. Ms. Holliday is from Steamboat, Arizona, and is the former 2019-2020 Miss Ganado Primary School Princess. She is in the fourth grade at Ganado Intermediate School and has been invited to perform the singing of the national anthem. She has sung at many sporting events and other special events throughout the community and the state of Arizona and New Mexico. We are very privileged to have her here today. Everyone, please stand for the singing of our national anthem performed by Ms. Holliday.
My plans are my education in Michigan, to the team, but his team, to bond, to the chair, to the country, missionary. I would have, may you guys please remove your hats or your headwear, and I'm going to do my prayer for class. Dear Heavenly Father, Thank you for this beautiful day that you have gathered us here to celebrate the class of 2022 and share the achievements with family, friends, staff, and board members. We ask you to continue push us and move forward as this is a new step to a new beginning of our lives. I ask that you watch over, protect, and guide us as we continue forward to make good decisions for ourselves. May today be a memory that burns bright in our future and we embark in life's great adventures. Amen. Yeah.
Thank you, Cabell. You may now be seated. At this time, I would like to introduce our esteemed platform guests. We have Superintendent Dr. Dobiash. Governing Board President Marcarlo Lonehorse, Ganado Unified School District. Governing Board Member Teresa Sells Gorman. Governing Board Member Judy James. Governing Board Clerk Ms. Wanda Begay. To my right, we have Mr. Chris McNabb, our assistant principal. Council Delegate Vince James from the Ganado Chapter. Our keynote speaker for today, Dr. Leandra Thomas. We have special guest, Mr. Leonard Alsosi from the Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company. And at this time, I am pleased to bring to the stage the senior class of 22 president, Mr. Zach Thomas.
Hello everybody, excuse me, I'm very nervous. Y'all today should add Zach Thomas and Shen, Buddy is teaching and Shen, now I'm having an end. But she's teaching, Tim Baha, but she's sitting at Jenny Dushanelli. They can't get out of here, they're not shot. Shmarto, she's your air, Candace and Arlo Thomas, well, yeah. Hello, my name is Zach Thomas and I am your senior class student council president. Good afternoon, students, staff, faculty, family, and friends. Alumni of Ganado, special guests, school board members, and a special good afternoon to the Ganado High School graduating class of 2022. We did it! Ganado High School hasn't had an in-person graduation in 2 years, and I bet when you told your family about the no limit capacity, they were like, oh, we're going. And I want to say for the class of 2020 and 2021, I want to say that we're deeply sorry for what happened to you and what you couldn't have today. You are recognized and I hope you can celebrate with us this afternoon. Now, these past 2 years have been nothing short of crazy. And by crazy, I mean Kanye crazy. Or Will Smith at the Oscars kind of crazy. Or State Line Fight kind of crazy. It is said that we've experienced a decade's worth of events over the span of maybe 2 years. The year 2020 alone will be in its own chapter in history books. From beginning a 2 week break from school to living in a global pandemic. During quarantine, we all had that, I'm gonna exercise every day, I'm gonna eat right, have clear skin, goals. We're working hard and treating ourselves and we take that one cheat day. 15 pounds later, you never should have taken that cheat day. It amazes me as we reminisce upon when we were innocent freshmen taking our very first steps on campus, blissfully unaware of how vicious the seniors would be, and then all of a sudden having our student lives being turned upside down as we entered a global pandemic our sophomore year. I feel as though our high school experience has been nothing unlike any other. I mean, they told me high school was gonna go by fast, but I didn't think it was gonna go by in a Zoom. Get it? As both past and future generations can't compare our story with theirs, from being excited about a two-week break to not going back to school 2 years later, it tested our determination, self-motivation, resilience, and faith. We not only as students needed an update, but our schools and our nation needed to change. Our old ways were in need of a fast update, and we had to get the internet. Even though we used it for something else, like watching anime, of course Euphoria, or playing online with friends. But our schools and teachers had to work double to make sure that every student got the education we needed during the hardest times of our lives. Issuing hotspots, starting classes online, sending out computers, just to make sure that they were doing their jobs to the best of their ability and going above and beyond what was expected of them. No words can describe the gratitude and how thankful we are for our teachers, administrators, and faculty. I want to ask every staff, administrator, faculty member to stand up, and we will congratulate them and clap for them one last time as they worked their butts off these past 2 years. So could you please stand? You may be seated. To those who told us we could do it when there was absolutely no proof of that, when we were in no place of motivating ourselves, criticizing our insecurities, when we hit our downfalls during school, they did their best to fix what was happening around us. And those who read to you and taught you to dream, maybe they didn't do it perfectly. No one ever can. Maybe they aren't with us anymore. In that case, I hope you remember them today. I will. My grandma is hanging up behind me today. And if they are in this pavilion today, I hope you'll find your own way to express your gratitude for all the steps and missteps that have led us to this common destination. And gosh, how we miss sports. Oh my God. During the time of quarantine, our native youth has never been so inactive. Hearing the news about sports this year, or like little kids excited to get a new toy, or little kids excited on Christmas Day. But who knew we were so out of shape? Starting sports was exciting, but it was a challenge not only for me, but for everyone who tried out for each sport. Having insecurities about our bodies and acne only made us work harder to have confidence in ourselves and in our bodies. Due to competition and hard work, we could tell everyone missed it. Even the teams outside of the reservation, coaches came up to us saying, "Oh, we miss you guys, you really put the competition in sports." That just shows how good we are in sports, honestly. Like, who knew we would be 2A North girls and boys cross-country regional champions after 2 years without sports? Becoming Division IV sectional boys cross-country champions and Division IV sectional girls cross-country runner-up. And going to state for both boys and girls cross-country. The volleyball team going to state, our wrestlers going to state and placing, having our first girls wrestling team, and the first Ganado female wrestler to become a 2A sectional champion. And that girl is my sister. She's over here, Lindsay Thomas. Yeah, don't mess with her. She breaks arms. She did. She broke a girl's arm in cage, and she qualified for the finals. Also, baseball and softball qualifying for state, which hasn't happened in 10 years. And track individuals going to state. So we not only put in the effort as teams, but as student athletes. We're not only making way for our future student athletes, but for the future generations to come. If we can live through a pandemic and have all odds against us, and still have all these accomplishments, then the younger generations can't say they had it harder. My goal is that those acknowledgments resonate with you when you look at your diplomas, so you can appreciate what you're grateful for. I know that having something to be thankful for, having gratitude for how far you've come and what you've experienced, makes tackling the challenges that tomorrow throws at you all the more worth it. I want everyone to remember this, so take out your cameras. I would like to leave you with a quote that was not said or created by the Mustangs, the Scouts, the Warriors, Wildcats, Thunderbirds, Eagles, etc. You see it everywhere now in front of schools, on gyms, but it was said in 2015 in this very pavilion by an alumni of Ganado High School, the one who brought home the only girls' state basketball championship, which is right here hanging above us, and made her speech to the senior class of 2015 as a guest speaker. She's in the stands with us this afternoon, my sister, Gabrielle Curtis. Please stand. Yeah, that's her. She's with Gabrielle Whitney now. And with that, always remember, once a Hornet, always a Hornet. Not Mustangs, not Thunderbirds. Once a Hornet, always a Hornet. Now say it after me. Ready? Once a Hornet. Period. I look forward to serving as alums together, and congratulations to the class of 2022. You deserve it. And remember, everyone, don't test positive, stay positive. Thank you.
Participated in throughout the school year. Thank you very much, Zach. I also want to thank you for recognizing our teachers as well, who have worked very hard to get you to this place and work with you to achieve this accomplishment here. At this time, please welcome to the stage the Ganado Unified School District Governing Board President, Mr. McCarlin Roanhorse, who will address the class.
Yate Shikado Shkene, Shay Ya McCarlin Roanhorse, Shet, Sanjikin and Nishlet, Kotsuni Bushes Team. First of all, I'd like to recognize our guests for attending our commencements today. We have valued people here on the floor. And so, students, I want you to take a look around. You did something very special and very powerful. You brought together our family, our relatives, our friends, and our community for a special reason, because of your education and everything that we wish positive upon you. So with that, ladies and gentlemen, let's give our class a round of applause. With that, I would like to ask my colleagues to stand up as we respect our guests. We have our clerk, board clerk, Ms. Wanda Begay, our board member, Ms. Judy James, and board member, Teresa Salzborn.
We welcome our relatives into our beautiful facility here, which many of us have walked through these same facilities, the same halls that you guys have walked through. We have dignitaries who came out to be here for you to witness this commencement. We have Honorable Vince James. We have our own homegrown doctor, Dr. Leandra Thomas. We have individuals in the crowd. I know I got notice that our state representative, our state senator, Teresa Hatafi, had joined us. So I'd also like to recognize her for being here with us. That's how important each and every one of you are today. I would also like to recognize our superintendent, Dr. Doviash, and also our teaching staff. Teaching staff, all of the staff across the district, please stand. If it wasn't for these individuals who are here, and the individuals who taught you for the last 13 years, we wouldn't have the intelligent people who are before us, who are about to start their lives, their career, and come home and help us establish and make our home beautiful, wonderful. And I want to thank our staff and former staff members for doing so. A kyaha from the bottom of my heart. Parents, grandparents, aunties, uncles, siblings, a kyaha for being here, for doing your due diligence, for contributing to your children's education. Like our student had indicated earlier, for the last 2.5 years, we were challenged and we had to teach, contribute to our children's education, whether it was pulling out your old textbook, whether it was Googling it, using YouTube. We helped contribute to these children's education. So again, thank you to each and every one of you. Students, remember the people here. We will see this again in 4 years. When you go to pursue your education, we will see you there. As the net, we are across the world and we support one another. So with that, congratulations, class of 2020. Let's look forward to seeing what you guys can produce. Yeah, thank you all.
Thank you very much, Mr. Rome, of course, for that welcome and encouragement to our graduates here. At this time, it is an honor and a privilege to play a message to our students from the Navajo Nation President, Jonathan Nez.
Hello everybody, Jonathan Nez here, Navajo Nation President Yat E Shikero Shana Adet Danhinatgi Do Da Isanotsagi Arokon Khalchin Da Istagi La Go Ganado Hornets Nihidi Nido Leth Class of 2022 Nihina Nishida Shalchin Ba He Nitsin Kodo Shikero Shana Da Isanotsagi Amado Je Che Masan Anala Nothinigi He La Kodon Khalchin Biken Sonzon I just want to say to the graduates, congratulations, moms and dads, grandmas, grandpas, nollies, aunties, uncles, all the relatives. Good job for supporting your graduate, the Ganado Hornets graduates for the class of 2022. And we all also want to just have a moment of silence for what happened in Texas. And, you know, we don't want that to happen here, but I know with the help of our parents, our leadership on the Navajo Nation, you know, we can push back on that. So let's do a moment of silence. Oh, Our thoughts and prayers go out to the families that have been impacted, directly impacted by the school shooting and the folks who lost loved ones. Our thoughts and prayers go out to them. You know, diha ishi nihil ya ishni to question tsagina hast eats atta. Al kida ish masando, masan, a chedan linigi da nihilaha et ishin led banda al degi. Edats and nihil ya dosne. Kaila ya yelt hitler and so bansas kiss. Didats at the question tsagina hast eats atta and so. A condeshi, diha et ishi, biga banda al deit o de belet ho nand. Lagana bekeyat. Eidads a techninso. A conde, nihe old Intonian and tin aboltra ecodor, doda hado nista di nebekeyap car. Nihe old Inston, din hina and tinigi benachi edo, do nista, chicken of lean. Din lay Texas jet hot inigi e, do by here linda. Ado ajito a mother oje a che, masan nal, dan linigi. Bada ultra agido dan lenigi ebatsu deals in Shikino clean. Aron hido con diha ishin yishiaish nigid up and nacha econ. Alkai J. You know, young people, we helped out throughout this very difficult time, 2 years of this pandemic. And I know the Ganado Hornets were out there helping out their loved ones during the height of the pandemic, helping out their elders, helping out their family members. You know, we were number one in the country, COVID cases. Guess what? You, Navajo people, turned it around. And now we are the most highly vaccinated people in the United States at over 70%. And elders, grandmas and grandmas, grandpas 65 and over, over 90% fully vaccinated. And you know, when people ask me, how did you do it, President? I say, I didn't do it. It was the Navajo people who persevered, helped each other out, utilize our way of life teaching. And you know what, since you all are graduating, I know some people will say, well, the students didn't learn much these 2 years. I beg to differ. I think you all were helping out your grandmas, helping out your grandpas, helping out your parents, maybe running after the sheep, taking care of livestock, maybe even, you know, growing some food, some traditional food in your gardens or farms. I mean, that's a lot of life skills that you've all learned, you know. So continue to put that together with what you have learned in the classroom, and you will be successful. I am so proud of you, Shachin. Also, the school board, the school administrator, superintendent, principals, all the teachers, the faculty, the staff, all the way to the bus drivers, to the custodians. Thank you. This celebration is also for you. All our graduates are crossing that finish line today. I'm sorry I'm not able to be there with you. You know, I'm here at Monument Valley. We're going to be signing a document, a settlement, the Navajo Utah Water Rights Settlement, to get water to the folks in the Utah area, the Navajo people. And we had some awesome help from a lot of people. But you know what? I have a special, special guest for you, ladies and gentlemen. And today I want to introduce to you the Secretary of the Interior, Deb Holland. And she's going to say some words to you, Ganado Hornets.
Hi, everyone. Congratulations. I'm so proud of you. I know this is a special time for all of you. You're finishing one journey and ready to start another. So I wish you the best future ever, and congratulations again.
Well, thank you, Secretary, and good job on the water rights settlement. You know, we're going to be getting water to a lot of our Navajo folks, not just in Utah, but all across the Navajo Nation. And we are so proud of the great partners. Of course, the first Native American woman to be the Secretary of Interior, and we're so proud of Deb Holland. You know, you all can reach that milestone, and we know that you all can do some great things in life. So have fun, be safe out there. You're going to college, or you're going to military, you're going to work, maybe just hang out and help out at home. Whatever it is, do the best you can do in life. And we thank you, and God bless each and every one of you. Go Ganado Hornets. class of 2022. God bless you, and God bless our great Navajo Nation. Bye.
We do thank President Nez for his words of encouragement and honoring us with that message to play for our graduates here today. Our next speaker comes to us with many accomplishments of her own. Therefore, it is quite an honor to introduce the 2022 commencement keynote speaker, Dr. Leandra Thomas. Thomas hails from Steamboat, Arizona. She is a 2005 graduate of Ganado High School. She attended college at Central Arizona College and graduated from Northern Arizona University, first with a Bachelor's of Science in Elementary Education. She has been teaching at the Ganado Primary School for 7 years while pursuing her master's degree in bilingual and multicultural education, and most recently, her doctorate degree in educational leadership, also from Northern Arizona University. Dr. Thomas was also a former Miss Navajo in the year 2012 and 2013 and contributed her time and efforts to address issues to assist in the reinforcement of a positive attitude and self-empowerment among the Diné people. Dr. Thomas was a standout athlete at Ganado High School and participated in cross-country and track and field, in which she won many athletic titles. She also competed on the college level. She continues her love of the sport by coaching our young athletes here at Ganado High School and Ganado Middle School as well, a few of whom have earned athletic scholarships to attend colleges in Arizona. As a coach, she earned the 2019-2023 North Region Girls Cross Country Coach of the Year and the 2020-2021 2A North Boys and Girls Navajo Times Cross Country Coach of the Year Award. She also successfully coached the boys cross country team to a Division IV sectional championship in 2020 and 2021. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Leandra Thomas to the podium.
Thank you so much for that wonderful introduction, Miss Sydney. I was sitting back here thinking, do I stand behind the podium? Will they see me? So I'm gonna keep my notes there, and I'm one that likes to move around and interact and make sure I make the eye contact with you. So with that, I just wanna thank everybody who has been joining us here on behalf of our children sitting here in front of us. Thank you to the family, your friends, all of my colleagues here at the Ganado Unified School District. Thank you for taking the time to volunteer your time, also helping here to make this a memorable event for our graduation class. Joining us today, all your families here, and this is for you. This is a time where they cautiously made their acquaintance and attendance here, where they're following safety measures, even though a lot of them were probably a little hesitant to join you, to join us here. But thank you for wearing your masks, your hand sanitizing. We appreciate that very much. And with you doing so, we're able to gather here again once again after 2 years of Hiahat. I want to extend my thanks to all the teachers, all the office personnel, office staff, all of our distinguished guests that are here, our board members, the family members, and of course, those of you who will be walking across the stage this afternoon. Thank you so much for being here. all your hard work. You are about to be placed, you're about to be placed with a piece of paper that will open more doors and more opportunities for you here in the future. In 2013, I spoke here to the graduating class. And during that time, I was a guest speaker and introduced as this Navajo Nation. Today, it's an honor and a privilege to stand here and address you once more, but this time as a graduate of Northern Arizona University as Dr. Thomas. Once again, Yate Ado She, Dr. Leander Thomas Nishe, Nakadine Nishnigo Sitnaji Shishin, Kia Anya Eda Shache Do, Hanagahi Eda Shanale, Ado Le Steamboat Sitnate Fasa Ande, Ade Jishike, Ado Dikon Shanan Shish Indi E, Ata of Dalfagi First Grade, Both Fanishle. So I teach first grade over at the primary school. And many of you sitting here, I've had the pleasure to teach your younger brothers, your younger sisters. With that, many of you know me as Ms. Thomas or Coach Thomas. I coach the middle school, cross country, track and field, as well as the high school. And many of you sitting here today, I do recognize you. I recognize you, I recognize your names on the brochure. You know, it's very amazing to see, I'm thinking, sitting there, oh, I remember them, are they graduating? So you see that, and it brings you great feeling to see that we are all here to celebrate you. Again, we gather here today for a special day. I want you to remember the best message that you hear today is not the message that you will be hearing. The most important message that you have been hearing has been from the last 12 years. The encouragement and the positive praises from your family pulled you through to right now, to right here. In fact, what you hear today from me are going to be simply reminders. We all have our unique journey, and yours is about to begin. There's one phrase, no matter where I went, it always pulled me through. Ahu ijit ego. Now, it has to be you. That phrase there in itself can have many different meanings. And to me, that brought me strength. That brought me the energy to pull through and overcome obstacles that I thought were going to be barriers and limitations. As a little girl, our family traditional teachings throughout the years were instilled to me by my parents and grandparents. Daily chores built within were the most important skills that brought self-discipline, perseverance, diligence, and stewardship. Our grandparents' stories, they shared many with us. Little did we know, at a young age, even for you, those stories that they were sharing became tools. They were tools for me, they will become tools for you. The stories they shared embraced us all with protection, guidance, and unconditional love. Over the years, the stories we shared, we made connection to life itself and how we will overcome monsters, negative thinking, and the no good doings. Your family did their best to this point to make sure that you were guided, you were safe, and that you were given the love and kindness to make it this far. They are committed to you, and they will be committed to you into your young adulthood and forward. Now, as you go off to college, the military or vocational trade or work, remember what you've been taught and the tools of your stories that will become your strength. Family knowledge, for me, was my go-to tools. Their teachings and their strength in the foundation of the Navajo saying, Aho Jik Ego, holds near and dear to me because no one else is going to do it for you. Shema Sunan always said, Yego Shiyaja, Yego Yisika, Amen Al Hajishin, Bikhe, Nijuligo, Nanishkotor Des. Now with that saying, you know, she said, it's going to be up to you to make that step forward. The things that you want are within reach. They're there for you. But you have to do your part and keep your feet moving. They also mentioned in Navajo, Lego to'o tizye, tega tizye, Yego nang kui, Yego didgosho, ni yein tito. They're telling you, go out there, go meet the holy beings. Throw up all that negativity. Get all that hashish out, that mucus, throw it up. So that when you go out there and you're yelling, you have that voice. You have that voice to stand up for yourself. You can stand up for others when they can't. Some years ago in 2005, I sat where you were sitting, thinking and dreaming. I knew the school I was going to attend, but I didn't have a set major. And as a young graduate, I thought I would become a veterinarian. I wanted to go into business, maybe sports medicine, possibly an aerospace engineer. Those were my thinking right when I was seeing where you were at. Again, at that time, I didn't know. Instead, I jumped around, changing my mind too many times. Now, speaking of too many times, you're going to go into that. There's going to be trails that are going to take you in different directions. You're going to have so many options. Keep an open mind. Because you don't know where those opportunities will lead you. Explore. Take chances. When I say take chances, I mean take good, positive, and make great decisions. When you feel it inside you, when you know something's wrong, that's called your instinct. Then it is wrong. In August of 2005, being the youngest, and the only daughter with three older brothers, leaving my mom was the hardest thing. But looking back now, as I made my step out the door, I hung on to that saying, Aho Jik Ego. It's gonna be up to me, it's gonna be up to you to make your step out that door and start what you want to be. This was my story when I started as a graduate. I wasn't sure what I was going to do. But eventually, I made that risk saying, okay, I'm going to try this class. Let's see how well I enjoy it. See how well I exceed in it. Eventually, my path would go straight. Now I started going different ways, different directions. You know, I like this. But eventually, it started at a broad spectrum, and on its own, it narrowed in. I found where I need to be. Teaching has found me. And with your where you're going to be, it's going to find you. You just have to meet it halfway. The schools I've attended all have their success stories. By now, any graduate will tell you that all you see is the success and the tip of the iceberg. What they don't tell you or share with you are the struggles, the challenges, the limitations, all the barriers that make you take a step back and make you wonder, is this the right thing for me? And listening to all those challenges, the implemented stories of our ancestors, you know, we become aware of our own stories. You become the authors. You have your own pen, you have your own paper. That's your life. You're gonna write your own book. You're writing your own autobiography. But I will tell you, I was talking earlier about those monsters, those barriers. I have met them. I know who they are. Your fellow graduates have met them. Your parents have met them. You probably met them in high school. You will meet them again. This time, they're not going to hold back. They are going to do their best to knock you on your feet. They're going to make you want to give up. They're going to make you do things that are not meant to be put in your body. These beings are not going to take it easy. They will be harsh. They want you to feel all the wrong and make life harder. When you meet these beings, you have to remember your strength. Remember your parents' and grandparents' words. These, the ones I'm talking about, are the monsters, the Nanye. They are the ones our ancestors have been talking about. One is Hoye, laziness. If you go on to where you're going, and that morning, your first day of school, you decide to sleep in, you already missed your first class. So I'm telling you now, that monster, laziness, if we yet throw it out. I know some mornings, because team, because some are so fun. They're really good. They want to keep you in bed. You gotta throw that blanket off. Fold your blanket. Show that you're ready. You're ready to take on the day. Second monster, you have the Bif. Bif A. You're gonna be tired. You're gonna be sleepy. No, there's gonna be that voice. Someone in your head is gonna be talking to you. Maybe it's mom's voice. Maybe it's grandpa's voice. Maybe it's your best friend's voice. Somebody will be there telling you, hey, what are you doing? Get up. Get out the door. Keep hold of that person. That person is the one that's going to keep you moving. The third monster, Slet. Jealousy. You see people. You see individuals. They have great things, nice things. You know, you envy them. Make your way where you don't feel that negative feeling towards them. Work hard. Push hard. Put in the effort. You pray for it. You work for it. You will get it. Monster number four, the chin. You will get hungry. You're going to be studying late, no matter where you go. You might be working late hours. You're going to forget about lunchtime. You're going to work through it. You're going to feel hungry. You got to make sure you're eating. Eating healthy, eating right. That will bring that positive energy, the positive movement that you need to exceed every day. You will struggle, but make sure you get hungry. You guys get something to eat. Monster 5. Poverty. Right now, you are all ready to go out into the world. Your family, you may know family around you, they've struggled very much. You have in your hands, you're about to be placed in your hands with a diploma. That's a key that will unlock many opportunities. Use it, take advantage of it. We don't want you to struggle. We want you to exceed. We want you to go in the direction that will make you happy. Work, employment, having the things you need, helping your family, giving back to them for providing for you all these years. That's what they're looking for. Most importantly, you know, going back and giving, exploring and then learning about yourself. Number 6, y'all. This one, you don't want to be sitting in your dorm room or your apartment when you start itching your hair. Y'all, if you don't take care of yourself, you don't take care of your personal hygiene, you're not washing your clothes, doing what you need to, it's going to take an effect on you. Again, these are those monsters that our ancestors have been talking about. Your inner spirit, physically, mentally, emotionally, you're going to be given all those challenges, especially mentally. You're going to be given homework, readings, hundreds of readings. You're going to be expected to read. Will you be ready for it? Anybody can stay up late at night. The challenge is getting up early in the morning. Get up early in the morning. That's what will make the biggest difference. Number 7. Old age. We're all working to do all the things that we want. And right now, we have grandmas and grandparents all with us right now in the pavilion. Some grandmas, they probably don't see well. They're not hearing well. But they are happy to be here with you right now. So thank you, Amasana Doche, Kwaani Kupuna Funki, Ayoba Kepa Nitsin Doko, Dikarachin, Dais Kaiki Penache, Dikoni Kupuna Flodo, Kunzaho Kodi, Shekia Hat. Those were the 7 monsters I was talking about. Ifuye, Bif, Flip, Dichin, Tei, Ya, Dosan. So you have your whole life ahead of you. Take care of your body. There's going to be people out there trying to influence you to do things that you're not supposed to do. Things that your mom and dad probably would not like to hear about. No, keep making them proud. Stay in school. They're not going to be there to drop you off every morning. Today, you will be leaving that nest. You're going to go off to explore, to make life, to do things that make you happy. Things that will challenge you. Don't be afraid. How many of you guys read the Dr. Seuss books? Maybe Dr. Seuss? You guys know who he is? Okay. Dr. Seuss. He wrote some interesting books. And if you don't know, he made stories rhyme. When he made them rhyme, he built characters. And one of them, I should say several of them, he had teachings. The book, The Snitches. You guys know the snitches? They go out and they go in the machine, they want stars. One person gets a star and they all say, oh, I want a star. And they all go through that machine. Now, I want to remind you, everyone's unique. You don't have to follow what people are doing just because they're doing it. You be your own unique person. You make your own decisions. Book number two, The Lorax. How many of you know The Lorax? You've probably seen the movie. Now, be an advocate. The Lorax was an advocate for the trees. He said, I am the Lorax. I speak for the trees. I speak for the trees have no tongue. You will speak up for the people. You will speak up for our Navajo people. You will get those degrees, you will get that job, and you will make a difference. You will make us proud. I can read with my eyes shut. That's another Dr. Seuss book. The book teaches us that the more you read, the more things you know, the more that you learn, the more places you'll go. Knowledge is power, and it will take you places. Speaking of places, his book, All the Places You Will Go. Be deliberate and be flexible in life. Be ready to take on those challenges. Again, do not be afraid. You are ready. You are here. You're ready to seek the next step. You will get mixed up, of course. So you already know you'll get mixed up with many strange birds as you go. Be sure when you step, step with care and great tact. Remember that life's a great balancing act. Never forget to be dexterous in death and never mix up your right foot with your left. With that saying, you will go places. Education has taken me places. Running has taken me places. Sports has made you see different places within Arizona. Keep taking those challenges. It'll take you to more places. You'll build more friends, build more network. Networking is the most important thing that you will build in your college career. Opening up, making connections with mentors, people who will make an impact in your life. I lost one of my mentors this past week. You guys probably heard of her or seen her books in your classroom. Dr. Evangeline Gauzy Parsons. She was a great Navajo linguist. Now, you go out there, find your mentors. If you don't have a mentor, now, I'm an email away. My first name, middle initial A, last name Thomas, at Gmail. I'm open to any questions to help you. If I don't know the answer, we will find the answer together. Green Eggs and Ham. Step out of your comfort zone. Remember the character Sam I Am? He was chased through trains and houses, the waters, and he finally at the end tried the green eggs and ham. Turned out he liked it. So with that, go out there. You might not like something. You might not like, or you might not be the best at math or science, but if you keep at it and you keep practicing, you're going to find those patterns. You're going to find the strategies to help you get through those classes, and you may find out, you know what, I do love math. I enjoy science. So take that risk. So some of the advices that I will leave you with is be ready for class. Know your schedule. Look for scholarships. Know your due dates. Be proactive. Know what to do next. Take notes. Believe it or not, taking notes is going to be one of your best friends and the best skill that you will develop in college. Have a planner. Save all your work. Set short goals and long goals. This one's probably most important and most relevant to your family joining us today. Call your mom. Text your mom. Text your loved one who is here today. Let them know where you are, what you're doing. Make sure you let them know you're safe and you are where you need to be. So you have your memories here at Ganado High School. You've made friends, you met them through sports, other schools. Use those memories and encourage one another, your friends. Push them, talk to them. Keep those memories to be your motivation to keep going forward. With that saying, Ahu Ijit Ego, again, it's gonna be up to you. So be happy, smile. Don't make the decision, I'll be happy until I win the lottery. You don't know how long that's gonna be. Don't say, I'll be happy until I get this job. You know, make it happen, start right now. Start now. Those people who wait too long, they're wasting time. Remember, when things start to feel overwhelming, take it one day at a time, one task at a time, one thought at a time, one moment at a time. Again, move your feet forward. Remember, it's all in your hands. It's all the decisions you're going to make. It's going to be up to you. So class of 2022, I leave you with this. Remember, you are your parents, your grandparents, your ancestors' answered prayers. They prayed for you to be here, to achieve and excel, to continue to grow by moving forward. Be resilient. Many lives were lost over the year, even over the course of the pandemic. We lost great family members, relatives, great friends, great teachers. The loss of those who shared memories with us impact our lives. Today we honor them by being a part of your celebration. They are proud of you. Class of 2022, continue your journey with more goals and write your journey and inspire your own stories. Continue to make yourself proud. Continue to make your family proud. And of course, continue to make your community proud. Congratulations, class of 2022. I can't.
Thank you very much for those words to our graduates, Dr. Thomas. You are certainly a role model for our students and have demonstrated through your success that the community of Ganado possesses many talented individuals. Thank you for being with us today. I now invite Ms. Charlene Kirk, Senior Counselor, to the stage to recognize 10 outstanding seniors of Ganado High School. Ms. Kirk. Good afternoon. Our students have had many accomplishments in their years here at Ganado High School. Their educational goals have resulted in high academic achievements, and today these students are being introduced as the top 10 students of the class of 2022. Would these seniors please come to the stage to be recognized? Michaela Mariah Batui. Camille Shandine Hill. Trent Jesus Montoya. Marissa Smith. Zach Ander Thomas. Kristen Chanel Baya. Aaliyah Therese Johnson. Abrianna Megan Lincoln. Whitney Naomi James. Jasmine Hardy. Congratulations on your achievements, and we wish you continued success in the years to come. Thank you, Ms. Kirk. Congratulations to these students, the top 10 of the class of 2022.
Exemplify the four pillars of the National Honor Society, and I ran the signature gold stole and blue and gold honor cord. Would these seniors please stand to be recognized? Zach Thomas, Jalen Brown, Lauren Burns, Austin Key, yes, Marissa Smith, yes, Jasmine Hardy, yes, Whitney James, yes, Vance So, yes, Michaela Bitsui, yes, Kalana Bitsui. It is an ongoing responsibility to continue to demonstrate leadership, character, service, and scholarship. Please continue to do so as you go out into the world.
Thank you, Mrs. Miller. Congratulations to those students for their achievement. I next bring to the stage Ms. Michaela Bitsui, Senior Class Vice President, to conduct the presentation of gifts from the class of 2022.
Yatze ama ajae to amasane ache to anale. She'e Michaela Bitsui Misha. And as there's a touching in this way, tell the heart, but she's seen to a hundred of the tree, and I can add that she knows. She not go to jae a for Andrew Nelson go Michael Bitsui Oya. She not send it go to jae a sherry go Philip Nelson Oya. She know a song Mary L. Bitsui Oya in the tent, auto. Now I just team A, keep it sweet for you. Look out into the day now, Sha. Good afternoon, parents, guardians, grandparents, family, friends, faculty, staff, distinguished guests, and my fellow classmates. I am grateful to have this opportunity to extend my appreciation and give thanks to two special individuals who are part of our commencement ceremony. Both my aunties. First and foremost, our keynote speaker, former Miss Navajo, Dr. Leandra Thomas. Can you please stand? Thank you. And to our second individual, someone who put up with us through the 4 years of high school, our senior class sponsor, Ms. Yvonne Rossi. I should have to visit Dr. Thomas for sharing your wise words of encouragement and your life experiences. During this speech, I liked how you mentioned that celebrating today wasn't just about our high school years, but goes back to when we started from kindergarten with the love, guidance, and support from our parents, family, and friends. Going forward, it will be up to us individually to use our voice to help the future of our people. Yes, we will have some setbacks, but we have to remember our strengths from our family, and do not let the monsters, big or small, tear us down. I'll definitely use your advice in the future. Through what you have accomplished and achieved, you are living proof that a Ganado alumni can attain the highest education, a doctoral degree. Next, thank you, Auntie Ms. Yazoo, for being our class sponsor throughout the past 4 years and through this pandemic. Thank you for your continuous support, whether it was from the late night concession sales, supporting and traveling to all our games and meets, supporting and traveling, unlocking our ingenuity and Alex us late at night because we were procrastinating, and staying after school to help us pass and experience a special moment. All your hard work, dedication, and patience for us to reach this milestone does not go unnoticed, as well as the positive impacts you have made on our lives. Therefore, on behalf of the class of 2022, I'd like to present and give our tokens of appreciation to these inspirational and successful women. You both are great role models to not just me, but to our school district and communities. Clap. Thank you. Akiha and Sago.
Thank you, Michaela, for providing the gifts, presenting the gifts for the class of 2022 to these very special women here on our stage. And thank you to Ms. Yazoo again. She's worked very hard to help to bring the seniors through their last year of high school. Let's give her a round of applause again. Invite Mr. Chris McNabb, the Ganado High School Assistant Principal, to the stage to introduce this year's class of 22 salutatorian.
My speech is 4 pages, but don't worry. I had to make it real big so I could read it without my glasses, so it's not too long or anything. Good afternoon. My name is Chris McNabb. I'm the assistant principal at Ganado High School. The graduates really haven't seen me around the high school that much this semester. I was reassigned to the intermediate school as the acting principal, but I didn't forget you all, and I really appreciate you including me in this special day of yours, so thank you very much. It's my honor today to introduce the salutatorian for the class of 2022. This year's salutatorian is Whitney James. Whitney is an excellent example of a true student athlete. She's been part of the cross-country team and track team throughout her high school career. This past season, she qualified for state track in 3 different events, which is quite a feat. She also is part of the prestigious Wings of America organization, and her running abilities earned her a scholarship to Central Arizona College, where she will continue her running career. And that's also where Dr. Thomas went when she left Ganado. In fact, I believe Whitney signed her letter of intent right here in the pavilion about 2 weeks ago, so congratulations on that. And academically, that's what we're really here for, is academics. She's very strong.
as evidenced by her being designated salutatorian for the class of 2022. She's also a member of the National Honor Society. She also is part of the dual credit classes through Northern Pioneer College, which is a program that allows students to earn college credit while they're in high school, and she was a part of that. So I'm very proud to present to you Whitney James, salutatorian of the class of 2022. Come on up. So I guess I have to put my glasses on. I'm trying to avoid that. This is to Whitney James, in recognition of your outstanding academic achievement in receiving the second highest grade point average for the class of 2022. Awarded this 27th day of May, 2022. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mr. Denard. Yes, Welcome again, friends, family, teachers, administrators, and of course, my fellow classmates. Today, I am going to give a speech, and to be honest, I'm really nervous. I just want to give a big congratulations to everyone for being here today. In this world, we do not know what the future holds, and who knew we faced a pandemic. But nevertheless, we did it. We watched one another grow up from having similar classes in elementary, intermediate, middle school into now. 4 years ago, we entered the doors of Ganado High School as freshmen, getting food at our first assembly and getting lost in the hallways of our school. Our sophomore year, we got a little bit more comfortable to be juniors with the endless Zoom calls we probably never attended, the 11:59 p.m. assignments, and daily reminder to log in for attendance, and the start of our procrastination. Sadly, I did not break the habit. For my psychology class for APC, a 10-page research paper was assigned at the beginning of the semester. We had a total of 5 months to complete it, and I did not start until the night before it was due. Given the opportunity of dual enrollment has taught me two things, a preview of college work, and I do not want to go to college now. Just kidding. My experience here at Ganado was definitely something. But ladies and gentlemen, graduation is just another step in our lives, the beginning of a new chapter. It is time for us to take on the world. There is a world awaiting many more of your achievements, accomplishments, successes, and adventures. Although I am salutatorian, grades or ranks do not define us because it will not be remembered. But you will be remembered as a type of person you were in high school and the friendships, relationships you built. Therefore, whatever you do in life, I wish you all the very, very best from the bottom of my heart. I wish each and every one of you, I am proud of each and every one of you, and I'm honored to be your classmate. Once again, congratulations, class of 2022. Thank you. Thank you, Whitney, for that wonderful speech. She has definitely set an excellent path for herself, and we wish her continued success in all of her endeavors. Next, I invite to the stage the class of 2022 valedictorian, Ms. Jasmine Hardy. Many activities throughout her years here at Ganado High School.
She has completed honors courses as well as earned college credits in the Northland Pioneer College Talent Program here at Ganado High School, which jumpstarts her college education. She has earned the highest GPA of the class, which is a 3.94. Please welcome Jasmine Hardy, the class of 22 valedictorian. Jasmine also is presented with an award today. It reads, Ganado High School valedictorian, presented to Jasmine Hardy in recognition of your outstanding academic achievement in receiving the highest grade point average of the class of 2022. Awarded this 27th day of May, 2022.
Thank you, Ms. Sydney. Yat Esh Ero Shremene, Shere Jasmine Hardy, and Shere Topahana Shlema, excuse me, Bushes Chi, Tuchi Nita Shere, Topahana Shemele, Shemada Shazaya E. Frank Sleen, Do Chi Party, Uya, Shemasane Doshache, E. Marvin Kilichi, Do Francis the Gay, Uya, and then Shanella his team, Shanella his son, and Mary Sophie, Do Key Harvey. Oh, yeah. Good afternoon, my fellow classmates, parents, grandparents, staff members of Ganado Unified School District. My name is Jasmine Hardy. I am 17 years old. I have 3 brothers and 4 sisters. It is a great honor to stand before you as your valedictorian of 2022. I would like to express my appreciation to all my teachers, family members, and especially my mom and dad, who helped me get to where I am at right now. I would also like to thank the administration for providing me with all the opportunities. It was almost exactly 4 years ago when I was leaving the middle school and heading to the high school. I know that some of you were scared and nervous, which you won't admit, but high school can be intimidating and tough. But for sure, it was a place for growth and success and to be more independent. We got the chance to share great ideas, passions, and strengths within that time, and we met new people. I remember the day I skipped second grade at Kilichi Ota. From then on, I knew that I was capable of doing many things for myself. Ever since then, I have been motivated and I pushed myself to study and complete all my schoolwork. I stand here in front of my fellow classmates as your valedictorian. Today is a turning point in each of our lives. We all spent the past years wandering the halls of Ganado High School, and now we are ready to move on to the next chapter. We need to be looking forward to our future. We will meet new people, make new friends, and learn new things. We sure will grow older, be more responsible and independent. Our lives hold up many surprises for us, but I am sure that everything will be okay. We will all approach some difficult challenges, but we will learn how to handle them and continue to move forward. I know that we all have been through a rough 2 years with the pandemic. I look over the many faces I behold today, perceptions of individuals are washed away. I no longer see people as they were, I see them as they will be. I can see my fellow classmates in the next decade being the greatest leaders and doing awesome things. When looking at the bright horizon, that is my future. I am happy. My heart holds joy, love, and success. I know my classmates will too. So don't look back and regret, my friends. Always look forward and smile. Always remember where you came from and remember where you are going. No matter what your dream is for the future, you can get there with the dedication, determination, commitment, and focus that you all have learned from high school and from your parents. I am also glad that I got a chance to talk and help some of you along the way. Thank you, students, for all the encouragement you have given me.
Now we have done it and we finished what we started. It's a blessing to see us graduate today, and let's make the best of it. I will remember each one of you and cherish all the moments we had together. You guys will be missed. Congratulations to the class of 2022. I wish you the best. Ayaha.
Congratulations, Jasmine, for receiving the highest academic honor at Ganado High School. I do look forward to many more accomplishments in your years beyond high school. Today, I have a special request by Mr. Leonard Alsosi, President of the Board of Directors of the Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company. This request will honor our class valedictorian, Ms. Jasmine Hardy. Mr. Sosi.
Yat is a case of the man. A chat he no hahon, a dot a shopping, a hot chat he's in the hole. Yat is a dish season. Ado a donna, a pretty big hoya, shedding a nani, put it in the man. Ein Stilo, der ich hat so mit der Wasser schien. Nett auf dem Lehrt hat schien, dass ich schien, do, kia, ahne, ich das schon nett. Nei, echt die Toho, jedo, naho, konsto, era, a, pechstiko. A, da, ich sind auch schon, da. Sen, jan, da, ist die Toho, jedo, und ich da, ja, fieber, wenn da, den, am, da, ho, jen, so, ko. E, da, kei, ich, a, ja, kei, hier, die schien, ne. Ado da eya governing board, governing school board members, I'd like to say thank you, and then also the superintendent of the school here, and then also the building principal, teachers and staff, and then also parents, Amado Ajeno Femini, Eche Amasan, and the Amela Hastido Mela Islam Femini. Adam Zonako, Nafa Shinan Vinidi, Pita Hosidon Lema, Honzate, Ber Oho Ahnatin Eke, Tin Vinidi, Iki Yado, Dita Eko, Pitato Yak, which I hold Jishida, Eke, Ado Dita E, just want to do a special recognition for one of your fellow graduates here. We have an exceptional student that came in a wheelchair. She's sitting over there. You all could stand up and clap your hand for her. And fellow graduates, I went to the various high schools throughout for the past 2 weeks. I learned there are some students have lost their parents, but they nonetheless they excel academically. And then some of them have lost their horse 3 days before graduation. What's on that call? And then just about a couple of hours ago, I went to Wonder Rock High School. And Dr. Luba Dehozy was in attendance. She's 95 years old, going to be 96 in, next month in June. But she got her honorary doctorate. And also right here you have your fellow student that's is an exceptional student. Those are some things you remember. When time gets tough, think about those things. If your fellow student can make it, you all can make it, right? I hope that comes. It's nice to say that. And Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company is a company that's been formed back in 1993. It's a company that belongs to the Navajo people, from the youngest to the oldest, in that there are agreements made with the Navajo government. When we produce oil, we give so much back to the people and to the chapters. And this year, what we wanted to do is to recognize our valedictorians. So we wanted to recognize our valedictorian here today at Ganado High School. And we're going to present a plaque. The plaque reads, Certificate of Scholarship in the Honor of Outstanding Academic Performance. Navajo Nation Oil and Gas Company presents Jasmine Hardy with a Scholarship Award of Excellence, May 27, 2022. That's the plaque we're going to present. And then also a $1,000 check to her. And this check is not a hardship check. It's a check for academic excellence. She can use it towards her college. It was mentioned that she is taking colleges now, college classes. So with that, I'd like to present this to Jasmine Harding. A very good job you did. Thank you.
Mrs. Lucille Sidney, that you have successfully completed all of the requirements of the basic educational curriculum of the Ganado Unified School District. I hereby confirm your graduation this 27th day of May, 2022, here at Ganado High School and award you this diploma. This diploma is awarded to you with all the rights, powers, honors, and privileges pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Ms. Yvonne Yazzie, senior class sponsor, will call the roll for the presentation of diplomas. Ms. Yazzie was the senior class sponsor and is a math teacher here at Ganado High School. With the first row, please stand and come forward. Thank you.
Theo Barney. Daniel Begay. Darby Begay. Doris Begay. Edison Begay. Jervis Begay. Kobe Begay. Nicole Begay. Olin Bial. Kristen Chanel Meyer. Layla Fire. Bryson Billy. Rachel Billy. Kilana Najoni Batui. Michaela Mariah Batui. Tyron Batui. Keenan Bazzardi. Jalen Helene Brown. Khaled Buck. Lauren Alicia Burns. Shantae Chanel Charlie. Seamus Chi. Rolanda Crank.
Rolanda.
Shia Curtis. Maya Nicole Dalgard. Caitlin May Denexo. William Davis. Belle DeBoe. Kenny Docito. Wyatt Earl. Armando Esparza. Giovanni George. Jaden Gishi. Camille Shundin Hill. Jasmine Hardy. Rogue Riley James. Simon James. Whitney James. Leticia Jesus. Aaliyah Johnson. Jaden Johnson. Canijo. Hannah, excuse me, Montel Canijo. Jaselyn Keys. Austin L. Key. Sherman Z. Key. Lisa Lynn King. Alton Kirk. Tyrell Lee. Abrianna Megan Lincoln.
Alton.
Sean Luna. Shabeo Manny. McKenna Manuelito. Nina Therese Minosa. Dorian Sean Miles. Mackenzie Monroe. Trent J. Montoya. Corbin Nelson. Linnea D. Nelson. Cordell Nez. McKenna Overturf. Melanie Owens. Jasper B. Peptoni Jr. Jerome W. Peptoni. Maya Marie Phillips. Jacob Alexander Pina. Cole K. Pino. Noel Ramon. Jordana Ross. Sean Ross. DeAndre Shepherd. Benay Garcia Shorty. Autumn Rose Smith. Kiona Smith. Marissa Marie Smith. Marcus Smith. Matthias C. Smith. Cabell Luke Stewart. Come out. Brandon Ben Keller. Zach Andrew Thomas. Zach. Jordan Thompson. Linnea Yenabok Tracy. Paul Edward So the Fourth.
Good afternoon to my fellow classmates, families, and school faculty. Thank you for coming to today's commencement ceremony. 3 years ago, we walked through the doors of Ganado High School for the first time. We lost our whole junior year, we lost a whole summer, and many of us lost loved ones. And yet, despite all the tragedy we endured, we made it. We are here. This last year taught us that no matter what life throws at us, we are strong and more capable of overcoming setbacks and challenges. So with that said, the moment we've all been waiting for, graduates, class of 2022, at this time, please turn your tassels from left to right. Congratulations, class of 2022. Graduates may now be seated. To provide our closing remarks to the class, please welcome Ms. Tiasha Vessel Ames, Ganado High School math teacher.
Yeah! Woo!
Okay, no more math lessons, but this is a life lesson, probably the most important words I have to tell you, class of 2022. So good afternoon, born and land. Good afternoon, graduates. My name is Tiasha Vessel-Ames, and I'm a math coach here at Ganado High. It is a great honor to be asked to say a few closing words for this special occasion, honoring you, the class of 2022. You know, as I thought about what to say to you, I was flooded by memories of you as freshmen. You were young and goofy and full of energy. Some of you were eager to tackle high school learning, while others were hesitant and unprepared. But you studied, you learned, and though you may have struggled at times, you improved and even excelled. So when the pandemic hit, we were all thrown for a loop. Everything normal became new. Everything new became challenging, it became hard. But you persevered. You met the challenges head on. And today, you are here, about to embark on the greatest time in your life. To be young, to be a young adult is an incredible opportunity. You must meet it with all the vigor and the strength that brought you here. You have already proven yourself, proven that despite unprecedented barriers to learning, you have it in you to overcome them. But now you will face new challenges, and yet you must use that same strength and determination to move forward into adulthood. It is a tricky time in life, not unlike launching a tiny sailboat into the vastness of an open ocean. You must stay the course and not let the rough seas and powerful winds steer you from your dreams. If you look inside yourself, you will find a diamond. We all have them. It is this diamond that gives us not only strength, but direction. It is made of your passion, your bliss, whatever it is that burns inside of you to become. You must summon the courage to push on, because it is this passion that is the key not only to happiness, but to success. But finding and pursuing your passion requires more than strength. It requires compassion and kindness, not only to others, but to ourselves. I cannot emphasize this enough. We all make mistakes. We all wish we could have done some things differently. But the key is to remain humble and observant enough to learn from our experiences. Learning is a lifelong process, a lifelong commitment, much like a marriage, and it begins with questioning. Information is all around us, but we must be diligent enough to find the facts in our search for truth, and then we must be open-minded enough to accept those facts, even when they go against our prior beliefs. This takes incredible strength, but you have already proven you have that strength within you. Open-mindedness also means being curious about everything in life, and it means purposefully seeking out new experiences, because that is what adds richness to our lives. It is the secret sauce to lifelong learning, as well as lifelong happiness. And it is curiosity in combination with compassion and action that can change the world. So let courage and curiosity steer your ship through the deepest ocean, tackle the biggest waves, and weather the harshest storms. But as you steer your ship, always be mindful of the world around you. One of the greatest gifts you can give the world is to live purposefully and to teach by example. Let others see the courageous, curious, and compassionate way you lead your life. Let them see the way you question everything with a smile. Let them see the way you learn from your mistakes and the sisterly and brotherly way you interact with those around you. A smile is more than just an expression. It is a doorway into relationships, a doorway to working with others, a doorway to changing the world. None of us can do anything on our own. Humanity has overcome our greatest challenges by teamwork. So, cooperation is humanity's superpower. We need each other to survive. We need each other to thrive. And we need each other to make this world a better place. So, tap into your support system and develop new ones. No dreams are too big or too small. None of us is insignificant. We all matter. You all matter. We can make a difference, each of us. And remember that failure is only an opportunity to learn. Opportunities for learning and growth are all around us. So grab the bull of your life by the horns and steer your ship the only way you can. It has been a tremendous honor to be part of your high school journey. Congratulations, class of 2022. You have earned this day, and I know you will continue to make us proud. We are all rooting for you and your bright future. Now get out there and show the world what a hornet can do. And don't forget to smile. Again.
Thank you very much, Ms. Ames. Congratulations, class of 22, on this achievement of earning your high school diploma. In closing of our commencement exercises, I extend to you all sincere well wishes in your pursuits beyond high school. Families and guests, please join us in celebration of the class of 22 as they exit the pavilion. This concludes our ceremony. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Yeah, I've been getting the message. Yeah, everyone wanted to get it.